she stepped out the line, and I called her back like a day or two later. Called her back. I got a text message from you. Called her back. Call me. Let me know what's going on. What they want is that back and forth. That back and forth. So it shows that you still care about them. So I called her back. I still have not heard from her. Now I got another text message. Call me. I got something really important to tell you. It's a line. Whose line is it anyway? I don't know, but it's a line, and are you falling for it? We should be fishers of men, not just fishers in it. God finished it, so why am I still a fish? I should be a fisher, right? We should grow up in that thing. I told Miss Capro, if you look at the parable of the seeds, when we first become babes in Christ, we are the seeds, aren't we? Selah. House of bread, then thieves. In that parable, we switch places a lot. That's why that parable is so wonderful. Because you, as you grow up in Christ, you change places, right? You start off that God is the sower, and he's sowing the seed, right? So sowing all the seed into four different types of ground. If God has the seed in his hands, right? So he holds us in the palm of his hands. If God has the seed in his hand, and there he's being allowed to eject it, that means we have given our lives over to Jesus Christ, right? So these are all Christians that are being thrown. If you are being thrown as a seed, you are a baby Christian, right? But then when he throws you, you get to choose the ground that you land on. That's why you have some Christians that grow up real fast, spring up real fast, but then the sun burns them out. Because they landed on thorny ground, right? That's why you have some Christians, right, that get planted real well. But after a while, they just get, you know, verklempt, right? They don't want to do it anymore. They want to watch a church on TV. Because the cares of this world have choked them out. The cares of this world, the COVIDs of this world have choked the word out of them. And they do not want to come listen to the word that's been given over the pulpit. They feel better, even though COVID is a thing of, not thing of a past. We're still dealing with it, right? But it's a thing that's not a threat to us. They still want to watch TV from home. I'm scared. No, you're not. You're a liar. That's what you are. You go to the grocery store. You go to the doctor. Something's important to us. We make a ways and a room to do it. We make a ways. We don't stand in the way of the way, having getting his will done. God said, you are part of a body. Fail ye not to assemble yourself together. You are part of a body. If you're part of a body, what do we look like? Those churches look crazy right now. Spiritually, we're missing fingertips and kneecaps and chest boobs. We're missing pectorals. We're missing belly buttons. We're missing everything. That's my boobs. What happened? Why would you feel if you got one more that your boobs was gone? That's how Jesus feels, because you ain't there. You supposed to be the boob. That's the reason why I said it. Don't get it twisted. You supposed to be the boob. Why are you the boob? Because you're supposed to be the one who supplies the milk of the word for the babes in Christ, the seeds that are being thrown into the body. You're supposed to be one there to talk about the milk. After the pastor preaches and gives bread, they may choke on that. So the babes of Christ need some milk, right? So you're supposed to, if you're the boob, you're supposed to be supplying the milk from your teeth so that they can drink it and drink it down, right? But you're not there. You're at home, sitting in fright. I'm scared. I'm scared of COVID. My immune system is non-existent, except on the days that it's overactive and it's trying to kill me. It's non-existent, and I still go. What's wrong with you? And nothing wrong with you. I'm afraid it's a lie, because fear is a lie. Flat out, bubbled up, bubblegum wrap lie, and you stupid, because you let the enemy get over on you. He's blinded you. He said, let me just cover this, your eyes up with this duct tape. And you sit there like, okay, A-okay. And so he's covering your eyes constantly with duct tape and wrapping it around your eyes. I see it. And then once you decide that you want something, once you decide that you need something from the body, I am sick, I need prayer. Oh no, I need to go in. It's real hard though to unwrap that duct tape, right? That duct tape doesn't come off easy. As the enemy wraps your head in duct tape, pulling it off, you will pull out eyelashes, you will pull your hair out, because when you're told to go and not listen to the lies of the enemy, you stay at home anyway. So instead of you getting faith from this thing, you got false evidence appearing. Real faith is the substance of things evident, hope for the evidence of things not seen. You ain't got no evidence, all you got is false evidence, therefore all you holding in your hand is a lie that you keep telling yourself. Believes you. You ain't gotta convince me. I know you a liar. It's the Dunkin' Donut man. Time to make the donuts. Came to your door and say, can I come in and make some donuts for you? Sure. I need a donut. And when Jesus comes, you close the door real fast and lock it. You got donuts in one hand, and no one knows he's good. I got donuts. Wait, Jesus knock on the door, do not disturb. You put up a do not disturb for Jesus, because you eat your donuts. Because you will open up the door for the man that will make a donut for you. And got time to make the donuts, you will let him start this out your house. Because something that you want, that's the apple. That's that apple. The enemy comes in and he shows you that bright shiny apple, that piece of fruit that you want, that desire. Eve had sex with her desires that day. She had sex with the apple. Funny thing it was, Adam's desire was for her, and Eve's desire was for the apple. Everything was inside out. Because when the curse came down, the Bible said that your husband's desire will, your desire will be for him, and his desire will be for him. But at that moment, Adam's desire was for Eve. He was staring at Eve. He was following Eve around because she talked to the serpent, right? And then handed the apple to her husband. They say she took it home. She put it in a lunch bag and took it home. She handed it to him. She had sex with her desires. While she could have been procreating with her husband on the grass or whatever, I don't know how they did it, you know? She could have been procreating with us because she was charged to do that. His desire was for her, and her desire was for him, equally. But now, since his desire was for you, and you had sex with your desire, you turned your desire away from him, now your punishment will be is that your desire will always be for him. We don't know what he's going to want. He'll marry you, but will he always want you? And you feel like you're doing everything that he's telling you to do. But will he always desire you, what you got? Will you always have something that he will desire, he will run after? Will he drop everything like it's hot just to come after you when he sees you? That's my wife, Eve. I need her all over me. I don't know. You had sex with your desires that day, didn't you? I set a purpose for me that way. My God told me, he told me that. He said she has sex for her desires. Because she's supposed to desire her husband. You are supposed to desire, meaning that's a verb. You're supposed to do it. But you turned it into a noun when you looked at what God told you not to touch. You made what God told you not to touch into your desire, and you had sex with it. Why your husband stood there? You communed with that apple. You ate it and enjoyed it. Don't tell me juice wasn't dribbling from your lips slowly. You loved it. She has sex with that apple. What are you sexing? What are you sexing? Take it in my thigh, take it in my eye. House of prayer. What are you sexing? Or dinner thieves? The thing is, God is saying right now is that she stole that apple. The apple was theirs. The apple, the tree was theirs. That was for them. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil, that was there for them. The tree of life, we're supposed to eat a leaf from that. And we go into eternity, that's there for us. That's how I know we're going to walk through Eden before we go to heaven. We're going to walk through Eden. Some of us are going back there, I guess. I don't know. I talked about the specifications of my mansions. And I said mansion. Because I need a couple. I need one that I can share with Jesus. I want to live with me at one point. I'm powerful. I know. I believe it in myself. He said, ask you shall receive. So if I don't ask, then I ain't gonna get nothing. So I want Jesus all to myself. I want to share with y'all. Anyway, that's my big brother. I want to talk to him. I want to talk to Paul. I mean, I want to talk to him when I get up there. I'm going to ask him some questions, find out some stuff. But I want to talk to Jesus. I want to spend time with Jesus. And I want Jesus to sit there while I do poetry and listen to me. a little poetry talking about him, but I want him to listen to me. I've been the tree here. I became the tree, and I want to go up there and be another tree. I can't see myself doing anything in heaven but what I'm doing now. Blessed. Blessed to be a blessing, right? I'm not trying to steal any gifts from anybody. House of prayer or then a thieves. I'm not trying to steal gifts from other people and say, oh, this is my gift. I'm going to preach just like this person. I don't want to preach just like anybody. I want to speak just like God told me to speak. Do it like he told me to do it. They told me to put music behind it. Don't put music behind it. I don't care. I'm just going to put the word out there. If you give me a word to say, I want to do it. On crutches, on regular feet and shoes. I'm still going to defeat the enemy. Send the Lord rebuke you. Send the Lord rebuke you. Send the Lord rebuke you. It's a spiritual thing. I'm putting a seed out there. She ate the apple and spit seeds all over the ground. I believe it. She enjoyed it. That's why she handed it to her husband like that. Enjoy it with me. They had a menage a trois with the apple. Menage ma trois. Because then nothing changed until Adam ate the apple. Nothing changed. They didn't have a fall from grace until Adam ate the apple. When Eve ate the apple, there was punishment. And it should have been something that took place. But nothing changed until Adam ate it. Why? Because he was given charge. He was a king. He was a king over that paradise. He was supposed to monitor it. Jesus spoke to him directly. He did not speak to Eve. He spoke to him directly. So Adam was going off the direct message of instruction. He was going off the direct instruction. Eve was going off faith. Because Adam told Eve, this is what Jesus said. That's why when the serpent came in there, it was so easy for him to turn Eve away from it. But Adam should have taken his woman and said, remember I told you, Jesus said, don't eat it. And at that point, it should have been finished. It should have been, I finished it. Adam should have finished it right there. Because Adam was the first Adam. But then because he did not do it, and he did not finish it properly, the second Adam had to come and finish it. He finished it on the cross. Why? Because you could not finish it in the garden. He finished it on a tree because you could not finish it at that tree. You still ate that apple, so he had to finish it at the cross made of wood. Because you did not finish at the tree made of wood. You did not finish it. So because you did not finish it, Jesus had to finish. He finished it right. He finished it well. He had to finish it where he was at because you did not finish it. So finish him came into play. He had to let you die as a result of it. The tree belonged to you. It belonged to you.